Hello there, and welcome to Everything Coptic, and we may today want to question and wonder about the personality of the prophet Jonah. And let's begin with something quite obvious about the prophet Jonah. He is a prophet. What does this mean for one to be a prophet? He speaks the word of God. And at that time, the Holy Spirit did not make his home within humanity. This comes after the baptism of Christ. But until this point, the Holy Spirit would temporarily reside within a person and speak to them. Jonah, therefore, had a relationship with God. Was it a very good relationship? Well, we can tell by the story, and we'll find there are differing opinions regarding Jonah and his personality. Many demonize Jonah, while others sympathize with Jonah. So, on the one hand, he has a relationship. Well, then let's examine this relationship. The first thing we notice about Jonah is when he hears the word of God to go out to the Ninevites, he ponders that the Ninevites are evil people, so he decides he's not going to go to them to speak to them. So some think that Jonah is being disobedient to God, that he's trying to run away from his will, while others believe that Jonah actually was afraid of what would happen to these people. Now, there's two schools of thought there. Some believe that Jonah thought that he didn't want to go there and proclaim judgment. He didn't want them to be destroyed. On the other hand, there's another school of thought that says that Jonah was afraid that God would be compassionate and they would repent. They wouldn't die, and they would think, well, this man is a liar and nothing happened to us, and they go and they would kill him. So there's many different thoughts that could come into the mind of Jonah. Now, another thing is, why then would Jonah try to escape the Lord on a boat and to run away? Oh, this actually, St. Cyril of Alexandria says that this speaks about people of the time. They thought God was just God of this continent, God of this area. But what Jonah quickly learned, and what we now understand and know very well, is God is God of all. And there is no limit to his dominion. So Jonah could not escape God by getting away from that land. He could never escape God, and he recognized that. And even being eaten by the whale, being within its belly, he recognized God's power, God's domination, God's supremacy, that even animals were obedient, even the storm, the nature. And then finally we get to Jonah giving his sermon, and then he sits under the gourd and he ponders about what's going to happen to Nineveh, and he's lamenting, and there's a gourd, there's a leaf that comes over his head, and it brings him great comfort. But then a caterpillar, a worm, consumes it, and he's greatly saddened and he wants to die. And the Lord comes to him in this condition and speaks about the lives of the people. And you have to wonder, it concludes at this moment, what goes on after this point? My personal interpretation of this has always been it's a continuing relationship between him and God, that Jonah is still struggling, working things out, as we too work things out. Yet Jonah, as all prophets, was seeking the truth of the Lord. And I think for him, although a prophet, I don't think all things were clear. And not all things were clear. There was still much darkness until the Lord, who is light, came and shined his light upon the Old Testament, the prophecies, all these things. And in that light, we're able to see Christ. And I think God is trying to teach Jonah here a valuable lesson about the value of human life and the value of God's will. And I think after seeing Christ, I believe that Jonah did truly understand how this whole work fit into the economy. To our Lord Jesus Christ belongs all glory and honor, with his good Father and the Holy Spirit, and glory be to God forever. Amen.